sheet, one piece of homework two, there's no name on the working sheet. So if it is yours, you can come to me after the class, okay? I'm going to do a review on Wednesday, talking about what kind of
Brooks,
questions that we're going to have in exam.
Briefly, I can't talk loud.
So. Homework one and homework two, and what do I have learned in the first month? We're going to have two questions in exam one.
It's
supposed to be finished in 1 hour. Okay? One of them should be hand calculated related. Shouldn't be anything related with ANSYS. Okay? ANSYS is going to be only tested in final project. Okay? And so please tell your friends, if they're not here today, to be here on Friday for the test and to be here on Wednesday for the review. Okay? And last Wednesday, at the end of the lecture, one student came to me, what is a boom area? You mentioned many, many times, what is a boom area? What is a skin stick model? Why do I have this? Today I want to introduce a little bit more about the boom area and the skin stick model. This is a realistic wing cross-section. Right? If you cut out the wing cross-section, that wing, if you cut out, you look at the interior of that wing cross-section, you will see this. You will see some stiffener. This is a stiffener along the wing length direction. And that is a skin. You always
It'll get boring really quick, don't worry.
When you look at the wing of an airplane, you always can have a look at the skin, but you cannot see the stiffener and the spar in the interior. You have to cut it out. So this is the realistic wing structure. What if you apply a bending or shear force on this wing structure?
Kind of both.
This is the length direction, right? If you bend this wing structure along this direction or that direction or that direction or that direction, you push this wing structure along three different Cartesian directions, some loadings should be carried by this structure, right? So what kind of loading should be carried by the stiffener? Most likely is carrying the direct force, direct stress, or normal stress. This is the length direction. You bend this beam along this direction, push this wing structure downwards. The normal stress, or the directional stress, will be carried by this stiffener within the wing structure. And the shear stress, because when you apply loading on the wing structure, you will induce shear stress and normal stress simultaneously into the structure. The shear stress will be carried by the steam. Okay? So that is why this is the first step of idealization. This is the cross-section of the wing, and each of these is a stiffener. Okay? This is the skin in between. This is the skin. And we are assuming the normal stress, sigma x, this is x direction, this is y, this is z. Sigma x is carried by this stiffener because this is acceptable assumption because when you apply a shear force or bending along this direction, most likely the shear force, normal stress or direction of shear, normal stress along x direction will be carried by this stiffener. So then we make another assumption is assume each stiffener is a boom area. This is how we come here. This is the structure we are dealing with in hand calculations. In realistic ANSYS model, you can build the realistic model. Each stiffener, you can build the cross-section, you can build full-scale model. But in hand calculation, maybe we can do this. We are assuming sigma x is carried by this each boom area, and shear stress is carried by this skin in between. So this is a so-called structure idealization in hand calculation. Okay? And we also did some calculation about how to calculate the normal stress in each boom area. Each boom area, we have a sigma x, we have a formula for that. We did two examples, one is for wing structure, another one is for fuselage. And then we come to shear stress. What is the shear stress? What is the shear flow in the steam? Because we're assuming shear stress is carried by the steam. So this is a idealized wing structure model. We have four boom areas, and in between I have skins. So for each boom area, we have shear flow going outwards from this boom area. R is the boom area, and Q1, Q2, and Q3 is the shear flow going outwards from that boom area. Shear flow is a representation of shear stress. The relation between shear flow and shear stress is shear flow is equal to shear stress times the thickness of the steam. Right? This is what we have learned in 321. The relationship between shear flow and shear stress is Q equals tau T. And here you have a negative sign. Convention, by convention, is negative sign. Tau is shear stress, T is the thickness of the steam. So this is how we calculate shear stress in wing structure. And then how to do that? We calculate the shear flow boom area by boom area. So we pick out one boom area, R, from this structure, and consider it is equilibrium. We derive something. This boom area, R, should be equilibrium. And there's a sigma x acting on this boom area. X is going outwards the plane direction. So this is y, this is z. Sigma x is going outwards. So this boom area should be in equilibrium, and then we derive the total force should be zero, and then we derive this. This is the equation we obtained last time. The total shear flow, sigma qi. Sigma qi means what of the shear flow going outwards from the earth boom area, Q1, Q2, Q3, until Qn. In case you have n shear flow, okay? So what of the summation of the shear flow going outwards from the earth boom area on the left? This is the meaning of the term on the left. On the right, you have very complicated two terms. This one, AR, YR. AR is the area of the earth boom area, okay? We are dealing with this boom area. Each boom area has a value. Area value, because each boom area could be different in terms of area value. So AR is the area of that boom. YR is the coordinate of that boom area along y direction. This is y, this is z. YR is the coordinate of the earth boom along y direction. And similarly, this is the boom area of earth boom, area value of the earth boom, and ZR is the z coordinate of the earth boom area. So this is the meaning of each term, and IYY, IZZ, and IYZ is the second momentum area. This is the equation for IYY, IZZ, and IYZ. Area times the distance squared, right? ZC, YC is the center of gravity. So this is a equation for us to use to calculate what is the shear flow. On the left, shear flow is unknown. On the right, VYVZ, VYVZ is the loading you apply on this wing structure. Maybe you are applying a bending along y and z, about y axis and z axis simultaneously, you will have shear force along y and z axis simultaneously. So VYVZ is the loading, okay? So when you apply VYVZ on this structure, you will have shear flow in the structure. What is the shear flow? Use this equation. So this equation, when you look at this equation is only for one boom area. For that structure, you have four boom areas. If you want to figure out what is the shear flow in the skin, you have to deal with them one by one, area by area. Each area should be in equilibrium. Use this equation again and again. Calculate what is the shear flow in each skin. Okay? And last time we stopped at one example. I just plot the model. I didn't study it yet. This is the first example. So this is a very complicated wing cross section. This is an open section. It's not closed. Here is not connected. Here is not connected. This is for the open section beam, okay, wing cross section. This is the length direction, y along that direction, z along this direction. Center gravity are here. I didn't calculate the center gravity here for this problem. I don't have to. I will show you why we don't have to calculate center gravity, because this structure is symmetry about y-axis, right? Symmetry about y-axis. So the center gravity along z-direction must be in the middle plane of this wing cross-section. So any point should be symmetry about this y-axis. So center of gravity must be along this line. So we put a point there, center of gravity. We don't know what is along from here to here yet. Just put a point in there. Suppose this is center of gravity. And what are the dimensions are here? Length, height. This height is different from that one. This is the boom area. 250, 200, 250. This is the boom area of each boom. We have 8 boom areas. And this is the loading. Loading is applied along Z direction. There's no VY. So this is a setup of this wing cross section. Now what is the shear flow? What is QI? QI means what is shear flow here, what is shear flow here, what is shear flow here. In each skin, I need to calculate what is shear flow. So let's come back to that equation. This is the equation we can use. Equation for the shear flow for each boom area. Right? In order to figure out what is QI, we need to figure out IYY, IYZ, and IZZ, VY, VZ. We look at that term by term. For this cross symmetry cross section, I just put this equation right here. IYZ will be 0 because it's symmetry about y axis. Okay? And VZ is given, is applied, is 1495 newton, and VY is 0. Right? We only apply a shear force along Z direction. With this condition, that equation can be simplified, can be reduced. So on the left, still QI. Right? On the right, we look at that term by term. This IYZ will be gone because IYZ is 0, 0, 0, 0. And VY is 0. So one of the terms in the first term is gone. There's no anything about this. We only have this. So after you simplify that, you will get an equation is minus VZ IYY ARZR. VZ is loading along Z direction. IYY is a second moment area about Y axis. And ARZR is the area of each boom, and ZR is the coordinate of each boom. So what is IYY? IYY is AR, AI, ZI minus ZC squared. This is the equation for IYY. And for this symmetry cross section, ZC is 0. As I said, because it's a symmetry about Y axis. So ZC must be along this line. ZC is always 0. AI, ZI squared. And then we need to calculate what is IYY because we have 8 boom areas, right? So IYY equals to sigma AI ZI squared. And if we look at that area by area, we look at the first area. First area is here. The value is 200 ZI squared. ZI is the coordinate of this boom area along Z direction. In total, from here to here is 100, right? So from here to here, this is ZC for the first boom area. It's 100, so it's 50. This is for the first boom area. What about this? It's symmetry about Y axis. So we simply put a 2 before this term because we are counting this area and this area. Area. Area and then we come to the second one. Second one, the boom area is 250. Area times the distance squared. From here to here is 1/2 of the total height. Total height is 160, so one half should be 80. And also it's symmetry, so the seventh spoon area, you don't have to count, right? And then we come to the third one. Actually, third one is the same as the second one. Should be. Yes. So also 250, sorry, times 80 square times 2. Okay. 250 is area, distance one half of the total height. And the sixth area is the same as the third area. And the last one is this one. This one, the boom area is 200. Distance from here to here is one half of this height, 80. It's 40 square. And also the same thing for the fifth boom area. So this is all of the things. You count all of the boom areas to calculate what is I by Y. And this equal to, this is equal to 8.046 millimeter fourth order. Because this is area times distance square must be length fourth order. Area is length square, and you times the distance second order again. So this is I by Y. And then we use that equation. We come back to look at that equation. Qi equals to Vz Iyy Ar Zr. Right? This equation is valid for each boom area. And then we use this equation for each boom. The first one, suppose this is the first boom area, and it's connected with the second boom area only. So shear flow from 1 to 2 is noted as Q12. Q12 is the shear flow going outwards from the first boom area, is flowing from the first boom area to the second boom area, because you have another boom area here, Q12. So this is the shear flow in that scheme. This is the only shear flow going outwards from the first boom area. Right? So on the left, we only have one term. On the left is one of the is a summation of the shear flow going outwards from each boom area. But right now, for the first boom area, we only have one term, Q12. So this is Q12 equals to minus. Vz is given, it's this much. And Iyy, you just calculate it. So it's 2.5, this is Iyy. And Ar, Zr. Ar is the area of this boom. It's 200 millimeter square. And Zr is the coordinate of this boom along z direction. It's negative because it's, when you look at that structure, Zr is Z1. It's a boom area coordinate on a z direction for the first boom. So it's negative one half or 100, 50. And when you calculate this, there's a negative sign here, there's a negative sign here, so it'll be a positive sign. So according to this, let's look at the eighth boom area. Eighth boom area is symmetry with the first boom area about the y-axis. So what is eighth boom area is Q87, right? The eighth boom area is connected with the seventh boom area along that direction. So that is the shear flow going outwards from the eighth boom area. So what is this? We don't have to do the calculation. What is this? It's negative this much, right? Because it's symmetry, but this number will be positive 50 because this boom area is above y-axis. So Q87 will be negative 1.6 Newton meter. When you get a negative number, what does it mean? should be flipped, right? You are assuming this is positive direction. So that means your assumption is not true because you get a negative number. The shear flow, the direction, should be flipped after you finish your calculation. But in your calculation, you do not have to worry about this sign yet. Put everything going outwards. When you get a negative number, change the sign. When you get a positive number, that means your assumption is correct. So this is how we do the shear flow calculation. And then we come to the second boom area. This is the second boom. And we again, we already calculate Q12. We put this Q12 from the first boom area to the second boom area because we already calculated it's along this direction. That one is a positive number, right? Q12. Q12, we calculate it, it's positive 1.86. That is positive, that means the shear flow is flowing from 1 to 2. So we can put this shear flow at here. And then we put, there's another shear flow from 2 to 7. So we also, there's a boom area at here. It's 7, this is 1, and then Q23, because you have another one is at here, 3. So the first index is the shear flow, which boom area that shear flow is coming from, 7, 2. The first index is which boom area that shear flow is coming from. The second index is what is the boom area that shear flow is going into. So this is how we number this shear flow. Q27 and Q72 will be different in sign. Okay? So I put this index. If you get a Q, if you put a 27 here, you should change it, if you, you should flip over the direction. Okay? So when you have this, again we use that equation, Qi equals to Vz Iyy Ar Zr. We use this equation again. On the left, we have three terms for the second boom. Only one is positive. Q23 is going outwards from the second boom area. And then there's another two is negative because it's going inwards of this boom area. Okay, this is all of the shear flow acting on the second boom area. And then on the right is easy. Vz is this much, and Iyy, you already calculated. And Ar is the boom area of the second boom, is 250. So it's 250. And the Zr is negative again, it's below y-axis, is negative 80. So then you simplify this equation, 23 minus Q12 minus Q72 equals to 80. There's a negative sign here, there's a negative sign here, so you have a positive sign. And Q12, you already calculated. So that means Q23 will be equal to Q12 plus Q72 plus this number. I just copy that number. And this one is already calculated. It's 1.86. So you will have an equation. You have two unknowns, actually, for this equation. You cannot solve it yet, because you only solve Q12 at this stage. You don't know what is this. You don't know what is this. You just leave it there first. Okay? Q Q23 will be equal to Q72 plus 5.58. I simplified this equation. From here to here, I use the value of Q12 and I simplify this term, lump them together, this is what I obtain. Okay? So you have an equation for the relation between Q23 and Q72. That means according to the balance of the second boom area, you cannot figure out what is the shear flow yet because there's too many skins connected with that boom area. We need to use more equations. So we come to the second, we come to the third one then. Maybe we deal with the fourth boom area first. The fourth boom area is at the free end or that cross section. That cross section this is the idealized wing cross section. This is the first one, second one, third one. This is the fourth boom area. I already have the equation for the first one, the equation for the second one, and then I come to the equation for the fourth one. Why I'm coming to the fourth one, not the third one? Because there's a free end here. That means only one shear flow is connecting with this boom area. One equation, one unknown. I can solve. For the shear flow in this skin, you solve one equation if I start with this boom area. And then I come to this area. One equation, two shear flow. But you already figure out what is shear flow at this skin. So that means you can figure out what is shear flow at this skin. And then you come to this, use this equation. You can figure out what is Q27. This is 7. So this is why we always start from the free end, because free end will reduce the degree of freedom. Okay? So this is Q43. At the fourth boom area, we use this equation again, VZ, IYY, AR, ZR. As I said, if you start with the free end, there's only one unknown on the left, going outwards from the fourth boom area. And this one is the loading. This one is IYY, and the area of the fourth boom is 200. And ZR is the coordinate of that boom along Z direction, negative 40. Negative, so you get a value about Q43 is positive. You figure out what is the shear flow in the skin between the third one and the fourth one. And then you come to the third boom area. You will figure out everything. So this is the shear flow, Q43. And this is the shear flow from 3 to 2 for the third boom area. Only two shear flows connected to that area. And if that is in equilibrium, on the left, we should have Q32 minus Q43. Two shear flow, one is going outwards, positive. Another one is going inwards, negative. Right? And then on the right, I use that equation. This is for the third boom area. Area is 250. And value coordinate on our Z direction is negative 80. Negative 80. So you already have Q43. This one you can calculate it. One equation, one unknown. The unknown is Q32. Right? Q32 is 5.21 Newton meter. And then we come back to this equation for the second boom area. This is Q32. You figure out Q32. This is the equation from the balance of the second boom area. Two unknowns. 2, 3 is at here. 3, 2 is at this much. you just flip the sign Q32, you will get Q23. So on the left, this one will be negative 5.21 something, right? 5.21 exactly. And then you can calculate what is Q70. So this is how we, if you get some unknowns, just leave it there first. And you can figure out eventually, because everything should be in balance. Q23 will be negative Q32. As I said, the force index is the shear flow where the boom area that shear flow is coming from. The second index is the shear flow is going into. So it should be flipped because you are talking about different sign. And Q32 is that much. So this is Q23. Should be millimeter. And then use that equation, Q23 equals to Q72 plus 5.58. From this equation, you can derive Q72 is 5.21 minus 5.58. This one minus this one, right? So it's minus 10, minus 10.7. Up to here, you figure out almost everything. Let's look at the original structure.
We're doing the third bank. Are you?
Is it closer? It's
at 4:30 though.
This is one, this is two, this is three, this is four. And five, six, seven, eight. This is the original structure, right? And Q12.
It's
positive 1.86. So that means it's positive from 1 to 2, going outwards. And Q23 is, what is Q23? What is Q23? It's negative 5.21. So negative means it's not flowing from 2 to 3. It's flowing, are you sure about this? Q23 is negative. So it should be flowing along this direction, negative. And Q43. Is 1.49, so it's positive. Did I make a mistake? Okay, so this is all of the shear flow, and also another one is Q72 is negative 10.79. Negative 72 is negative. That means it should be this direction. 72 is negative. Other direction, yeah, this direction. So this is Q72. 72 is negative, means it's not flowing from 72, it should be flowing from 2 to 7, okay? Because you got a negative number for this index, okay? And then this is one of the things that we have calculated. And then what about the others? I calculated this one. Value is the same, direction is different, right? This is a shear flow on this skin. It should be flipped. This is a shear flow on this skin. This value is the same as this one, but direction is different from this one. So according to this, what about this? Value should be the same as this one, but going to that direction. And this one, value is the same as this one, is going to that direction. Okay? This is how we calculate the shear flow in the symmetry cross section. You do not have to calculate all of the boom areas. If you finish one half of this boom area, all of the other things should be the same in terms of value, but direction should be flipped. Okay? So this is a very complicated structure, but it's open section. When you come to closed section, it's more complicated. I'm going to do one more closed open section beam first. And then after that, I'm going to come to the closed section beams. This example, basically, the example I just presented is not in textbook, but the following example is in textbook. It's relatively straightforward. If your beam is very simple, this is your wing structure after idealization, okay? Channel section beam. There's no such way in cross section actually. But this is just an example to show you how to do that. And each boom area is 300 millimeters square. And from this example, we're not going to only calculate shear flow, I'm going to show you how to calculate shear center for this wing cross section. Okay? So this is why. This is Z, and from here to here, it's 200 millimeter. From here to here, 200 millimeter. From here to here, 200 millimeter. And the loading is along Z direction. This is the loading. VZ is equal to 4.8 kilonewton. Okay. So question is, what is shear flow? And then what is shear center? So-called shear center, I'm going to introduce after I finish the calculation of shear flow. What is this distance? Should be C. Shear center means a point. At that point, you apply the shear force, you will not induce any twist of this cross-section. This is the definition of shear center. If you apply the shear force exactly on the shear center, your cross-section will not be twisted. Otherwise, if you apply shear force here, 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 any other point other than the shear center, the structure will not be only bending, but also be twisted. So that is the definition of shear center. I'm going to show you how to calculate this shear center. So what is shear flow? Again, we deal with a symmetry cross-section. So that means Vy is the loading, zero. Vz is not zero. And symmetry cross-section means Iyz is zero. Right? So again, we simplify that equation. We use that equation is Vz Iyy AR, ZR. This is the equation for us to calculate shear flow. And IYY, for this one, is AI, ZI, minus ZC squared. And ZC is zero, because it's symmetry. ZC is the center of gravity along Z direction. Coordinates with center of gravity along Z direction. So it should be AI, ZI squared. And we have four boom areas. Actually, each boom area is the same. All of them are 300 millimeter square. And ZI is also the same for all of the four boom areas. From here to here, 200. So basically, this is easy. 300 is area times the distance square. This is for one boom area. You have four of them, same. So this is IYY. Okay. Area times the distance square, each boom area is the same. And the value is a value is 10 to 7. This is IYY for this cross section. Then we simplify that equation. We substitute IYY into this equation. On the top is 4.8. kilonewton. We convert that to Newton. And then this one is 4.8 10 to 7. We leave the length unit to be millimeter. and AR, ZR. Look at this, 4.8, tensor is 4.8, so it becomes minus 10 to fourth order AR, ZR. Right? We keep the length unit to be millimeter and the force unit to be Newton. Okay? So this is a simplified equation for shear flow. QI equals to 10 to minus 4 AR ZR. And then we deal with the force boom area. If this is the first one, this is the second one, this is the third one, this is the fourth one. So we deal with this one first. Shear flow, Q12, right? Q12. Free end, only one turn, is flowing outwards from the force boom area. So 10 to minus 4, A1, this is the area of this boom area, is 300 millimeter. And Z1, D is here, Y is here. So Z1 is positive, 200 from here to here. And then this is the shear flow on the negative 6 Newton millimeter. The unit of shear flow is force per length. We keep the unit of force is Newton, length unit to be millimeter. And then we come to the second one. Second one, Q23. And this is Q12. Second boom area should be in equilibrium. On the left, Q23 is positive, and Q12 is negative. This is this term for the second boom. What of the shear flow associated with the second boom. And on the right is 10 to minus 4 ARZR. ARZR is A2Z2 right now. So area is the same, coordinate is the same, in the force boom area. So then Q23 is Q12 minus 200. This one is minus 6. This one is another minus 6. So in total, it's minus 12. Right? So this is Q23. And then we do not have to calculate Q34 because it's the same as Q12 but different sign. The symmetry about y axis. Right? So we can actually. What I'm talking about is this. This is the structure. From here to here is minus 6. So that means this is 6. And from here to here is minus, from here to here is minus 12. So that means it should be this much, 12. Right? And what is this? What is this? Should be symmetry but different direction, right? So this is the shear flow in this cross section. I only calculate the shear flow from 1 to 2 and then shear flow from 2 to 3. This one I do not have to calculate it. It's symmetry about Q12 a different sign. So this is all of the shear flow in this cross section. And then next concept, what is the shear center? So-called shear center, suppose is at here, 4.8 kN. The definition of shear center is there's no any twist. There's no any twist means the moment induced by the shear flow should be balanced by your external loading. Okay, this is the meaning of so-called no twisting. Okay, if we take a moment about any point, we take this point. The moment about this point from the external loading will be 4.8 kN times Kc, force times the distance. I'm taking the moment of this force about this point. So this is the moment from the external loading. This loading should be balanced by your internal force, internal shear flow. This shear flow should be contributing to the moment acting on point three. So does this one contribute? Does this one contribute? Imagine shear flow as a force. Force per mass, right? So does this shear flow contribute to the moment acting on point three?
No.
No or yes? No, because this is a force. Imagine shear flow as a force. That force is acting through that point. So that force acting through that point will not be contributing any moment to that point, right? This is what I have learned in mechanics, statics. And also this one, shear flow is flowing through from 3 to 2. So this shear flow will not be contributing. Only this shear flow will be contributing to the moment about point 3. What is the definition of the moment? Force times the distance, right? So let's say it's Q21. It's a shear flow. This is shear flow. It's not force yet. So what is a force? Shear flow times the distance. Length from here to here is 200 millimeter. This is the total force on the top flange times the distance from here to here. This is a force times the distance from that point. 400. From here to here, total height is 400. This is how we calculate the moment balance. Okay? And this one you already calculated is 6. So it's 6 times 200 times 400. Right? The force unit is Newton. Here, force unit is Newton. And the length unit is millimeter. So the only unknown is C. The C is how much is it? It's 100. It's 100, right? That one is 4.8. This one is 48, something like that. You cancel those tens fourth order, you will get the distance. That means from here to here is 100 millimeter. This is the location of the shear center. Why this is important? You are going to apply your force at on this point. Otherwise, you'll induce twist into the cross-section, okay? Next time, I'm going to show you how to calculate shear center with that previous example. And on Friday, I'm going to have an exam. On Wednesday, please be here, okay?
Did you say please be here?
On Wednesday, please be here.
Oh, okay.
Because I'm not the same on Friday. On Wednesday, please be here.
Okay.
So, he's asking what?